feels like we're running out of time. Welcome back to CTV Morning Live. There's a little peek of the musical genius that we are about to speak to. He's a Juno and MMVA nominated artist. Allow me to introduce Mr. Karl Wolf. It's so nice to have you in studio.
Thanks for having me.
What a pleasure to meet you.
Likewise.
You just wrapped up a Lebanese fest?
Yeah, I did that last night. It was jam-packed. It was amazing. So it's the beginning of many days to come, right?
Mm-hmm. And how are you enjoying the capital?
Oh, I love it here. My family lives out in Gatineau, so I used to come here. I used to actually go out with a girl from here. I used to have a girlfriend from Ottawa, mm-hmm. Mooney's Bay. So I've known her for 3 years, and it was good.
Are you saying hello right now? Are we saying hello to her?
I am. Hey, Aaron. How are you doing?
Oh, nice. Yeah. Okay, so we're talking about your new album.
Yeah.
Finally Free.
Yes.
Dropped July 10th.
Exciting stuff. I mean, we first week sales were amazing, so we went top 10. Mm-hmm. We beat up Justin Bieber for the first 24-48 hours, which
battle
was fantastic. I know.
Canadian artist.
But not anymore, obviously. He gave me 2 days of, like, triumph, and that's it.
Have you had the chance to meet the Biebs yet?
Yes. He was actually, we did a show together in Toronto, summer fest or summer jam, and he came up to me, this was four years ago, took pictures with me. Carl, can I take pictures? And now when he sees me on at the Much Music Video Awards, he just does this. He just nods when he walks by. I'm like,
hey, oh, how
cool.
The tables have turned, eh?
No. It's all good. I know all these people. We were signed to the same record company anyway, so it's all love.
So what can people expect from the album?
Wow. Typical Carl Wolf thing, which is, bringing 80s back and you know, putting a reggae dancehall kind of feel to it. But I'm also messing around with some electro house and dubstep in my new single, DJ Gonna Save Us.
So popular right now.
So popular on the underground, mm-hmm. but I'm trying to bring it to the forefront and bring it to the pop level.
So you've collaborated with a massive list of mega stars.
Yeah.
Who's one of your favorites? Who pops out in your mind?
Snoop Dogg.
Why?
Yeah. Well, you know what? People think he's such a gangster and all that. He's actually a very nice man and a family guy as well right now. I know it sounds strange, but he's a really nice guy. We worked on a song called Triple R together. It was just for YouTube and whatnot. Mm-hmm. And he's a great guy. And I've worked on this record. There's 3-6 Mafia. Obviously, they won a Grammy.
Juicy, right?
Yeah, they're amazing. Juicy J. Mm-hmm. Yeah, he's amazing. Cardinal Official, of course, on Ghetto Love. And DeMarco, he's huge in Jamaica. He's a big reggae artist. So a good bunch of people.
How do you go about initiating a relationship and ultimately collaborating with massive stars like that?
Well, we've got friends in common. The music industry is very small. Once you're in, there's a small circle, mm-hmm. and we all know each other. I like saying that. Mm-hmm. So and that's just from friends to friends. Snoop knows this guy knows this guy, and so we're all friends, and we just kind of collaborate.
Okay, yeah. So you have to make sure that you're very careful not to burn those bridges then.
Oh,
eh?
Definitely. I mean, with Akon, I toured with him for 12 different shows, and we're friends as well, so we got each other on BBM and email. I mean, it's cool. It's kind of cool when you start to, you know, because they're like big stars, and then you're like in touch with them, and then, you know, it's pretty cool.
So you have to keep a very close eye on your phone then, eh? If you were ever to lose that somewhere, that's a list of contacts that somebody would want to get their hands
that's
on.
That's why it's right here, next to me.
Yeah, always.
They're like,
in
why are you
hand.
Bringing it on TV? I'm like, trust me, I have to.
Yeah, that's true, eh? Is it, if it were to ring right now, would you answer it?
Yeah, no.
No?
No. It's too early, man. They know I'm not awake right now.
Look at that. Typically, right? Did we drag you out of bed early
you
today?
You did, obviously. I've got the shades on. You're not seeing my eyes right now.
No?
No.
We can't coax you to take them off?
No way.
Where are you off to next?
I'm going to Toronto. I've got two shows on Saturday. Mm-hmm. So just busy doing a lot of promo for the album. We're going to Kuwait as well. Just got back from Dubai doing the Pitbull tour. Mm-hmm. And so just traveling the world. We went to Germany, Austria, Switzerland as well. Things are working out.
Your career has really offered you so much.
Yeah, well, thanks to you guys. Thanks to everybody in Canada and, of course, in Ottawa for supporting me.
It's our pleasure. So if somebody wanted to travel down to Toronto this weekend to catch your show, where would they go?
They would go to Dundas Square. Mm-hmm. That's where it's happening. It's called the Live Green Festival. Mm-hmm. And I'm performing there as well as Faber Drive and a bunch of different other Canadian amazing talent.
Mm-hmm. You a fan of Toronto?
Oh, yeah. I mean, I live out there right now. I've got two condos there. So I'm doing, okay, I know.
Who needs two condos?
I need more. We need the 10. So we're working on that. No, I'm getting into real estate.
You know? Okay.
Yeah, so I'm renting them out and doing my thing.
And where do you spend the majority of your time? Is it Toronto?
Toronto, mainly. You know what, honestly, out of my suitcase, I travel the world. It's really sad sometimes. I don't have a home. So all my, like when we come back from tour, all the guys in my entourage and my band, they're all excited to go home because they got families. Mm-hmm. I go back to nothing. Don't feel bad for me, but I go back to just being by myself.
Karl, I'm sorry. With all your success, I have a hard time feeling sorry for you.
You shouldn't.
I really appreciate you coming on the show today.
Thanks
what a pleasure to
me.
Chat with you.
Oh, likewise. Thank you.
And a reminder that Karl's newest album, Finally Free, dropped July 10th, and people can pick that up at iTunes, obviously.
iTunes, definitely. You can go to HMV, any record store. It's everywhere. Go get it. It's a hot record, and you're supporting a Canadian talent.